Hello, people of all kinds. Scorching Cliffs here. And yesterday we were blessed with Crown the Empire's new single titled Zero. They were teasing the shit out of this just on Instagram and stuff. And I was like, come on, just release it already, please. And they did not disappoint with this new single. The opening guitar riff to this song just instantly grabs your ears, instantly pulls you in, and you instantly just want to hear the full song. And it's only 3 minutes, which is a little bit short, but we'll get to that in a minute. But yeah, this song did not disappoint. It was epic. It was everything I kind of wanted from a Crown the Empire new song. And I'm definitely hella excited for this new album. The chorus has that epic, uplifting feel that a Crown the Empire songs usually have, but at the same time, I think I actually like the verses more, surprisingly, which I don't usually like in Crown the Empire. I don't hate them or dislike them there really, but the choruses are always like noticeably stronger in Crown the Empire songs. In this song, I feel like it's just consistently great throughout, in both the verses and the chorus. And I think part of that is that they don't just do some one-note riff that they did. They did that a lot on The Resistance, where they just kind of used a lot of generic metalcore riffs and then kind of made them interesting by like putting like sirens and you know, weird chants like in Bloodline over them to make them interesting, and that was cool, but it still has generic riffs. But here they still have interesting details and layers of like synths going on in the background, while they still got this awesome guitar riff that uses like, you know, more than one note and isn't just fucking genting it all the time. Got a great balance here as well between kind of pleasing the fans and also having a single that is somewhat radio friendly and could definitely create new fans for this band and therefore more hype for the album. Now this new song is only 3 minutes long, which like, that's not a problem at the moment for me. Especially, I mean, you don't want a lead single to be like, you know, 7 minutes long or anything, but my fear is that this song, while it is great at the moment, in the context of a full album, a 3 minute song is gonna feel kind of insignificant and might pale in comparison to some of the other songs if especially if those other songs, you know, knowing Crown the Empire, they could be great. So I feel like this song might get old eventually, and I'm kind of scared about that. But at the moment, it's great. I'm loving it. Okay. I just really hope, fingers crossed, that it doesn't just die on me eventually, because I get sick and tired of kind of just hearing this 3 minute song over and over again. But hopefully it will stand the test of time. So we've got great synths, great guitars, great vocals, of course, from both singers. But I want to just maybe point out some possibilities that they could have done with this track, which I feel like, you know, I feel like this track, even though there's nothing wrong with it, like, it's pretty much perfect in a way, but maybe there's some extra things that they could have done to make it just, you know, just added some potential to it. Like, I'm gonna list a few things, okay? Okay, first, when I first heard the song, and I heard David Escamilla's part, his screaming part that opens up the song, I instantly kind of thought, well, oh, is he singing? But he's not singing, he's actually screaming. But it sounds like he should be sort of singing. You know, like how he did on songs like Initiation, you know, like where he had actual singing parts, you know, stuff like that. I think he has a good singing voice, is the thing. But the band only really uses him for either backing vocals or, of course, the screaming. But this seems like a perfect moment for him to actually scream and, scream sing, if you know what I mean. You know, singing, but with that grit to his voice, that power to his voice, because he's a really great singer in that aspect, but the band don't utilize it enough, I think, and this was a perfect opportunity to do that.
I'm breaking static, I'm changing my frequency, if I don't speak out, then no one's listening.
Although I would have maybe liked to have been able to hear the synths a bit more, or maybe even had some more layered guitar parts, like some lead guitar that's significantly different from the rhythm guitar and the bass. because I feel like I can hear some really melodic riffs, but it's not really, it's more kind of the synths that are doing that. You know, you've got like, I think they've got like two guitar players. I'm not sure because I watched the music video. David's on guitar, but then one of the guitarists that, because they usually have six members, there was only five members that I could see in the music video, so have they lost a member? I'm not sure. But you know, you've got more than one guitarist, so why not use a lead guitar part in more of your songs? I feel like that's maybe something you could utilize more as well. And as I was saying about the synths, I feel like they're just a bit too quiet, and whereas they could have maybe been just a bit louder, like on the track Wake Me Up from their EP, Limitless. I really liked that song, but it had like a lead synth part and you could really clearly hear it during the intro and the outro. I would have liked to have heard a lead synth part like that, and there is kind of a lead synth part, but you just can't really hear it. It's kind of like so layered and so just overproduced that it kind of just gets lost in all the other instruments and it doesn't like stand out. Instead, they just kind of have Andy Leo singing, you know, Zero! Okay, I'm not really hating on this song at all, just don't get the wrong idea. Like, I love this song. I instantly loved it the moment I heard it. You know, the moment I finished it for the first time, I just wanted to rewind and listen to it again. That's how great it is. It just pulls you in instantly. But these are all problems. They're not actually problems. They're just potential things that could have made it maybe just stand out even more. Like I say, I'm not sure if this is going to stand the test of time, but we'll see about that when the new album comes out, and I'll address that in that video when I review it. Suggest things for me to review, like the video if you agree or want to see more of these reviews. You don't necessarily have to agree. Again, leave your own thoughts down below. And subscribe for more, and I'll see you guys next time. Ta-ta.